Wide World of Sports. 1973, one of the most memorable years in all of sports. A time when sports dynasties ruled. A time when legends were born and when sports transcended life. 73 also marked the beginning of a new tradition in sports. For over a quarter of a century, the Superstars competition, a celebration of sportsmanship.
He's gonna get wet. He started this business of pushing everybody in the swimming pool, and now...
Sinus is right-handed, so one. Sinus is hands down.
And that, of course, was an utter jest.
Jim McMillan to win the tennis.
A good start, and Dwight Stone is the block of Willie Gault right there with him. Herschel Walker headed.
Johnson relentless.
How about that? And look at that time.
Thomas on the inside.
Hey, Gillian is beginning to fade. It's going to be Elden Age.
Celebrating 25 years of great memories, the silver anniversary of the Superstars is coming up next.
Welcome to beautiful Jamaica. We're here for Nintendo Sports 25th anniversary of the Superstars.
The Superstars.
As the new day rises in Jamaica, the anticipation swells for an anniversary celebration. The great tradition of the Superstars continues. It's new competition for 1998. 10 events, cumulative point totals, 11 athletes set to rise up and find out who is the greatest of them all. Event. It's getting underway. Dan Dierdorf, Dan Fouts with you here in beautiful Jamaica.
Half Moon Bay Resort and Sunset Beach is the venue for these first of 10 events, the kayaking. Bob McElwee, an NFL official, is now our commissioner, Dan.
And he's giving some final instructions to the competitors. And if you want to pick up a few tips on kayaking, hey, let's get it from a couple of friendly Jamaicans.
Welcome to kayaking.
Three lanes.
Fast times are best.
Top three will make the final, no problem.
From Jamaica, it's the first of 10 events.
Well, set to go in our first heat in lane number one from the Minnesota Vikings, Jake Reed.
Hey! It's the first time I'm doing this. Should be fun.
The man in the middle, lane number two, J.J. Stokes from the 49ers.
But I just gotta work on keeping it right down the middle.
And in lane number three, Herschel Walker. Herschel has been here before. He has some experience.
You know, it's funny, I'm from Georgia.
And the closest I ever been to water was in a pond. And now they're telling me that I have to kayak in this. This is a ocean, meaning that it's deep. So this is something I'm not used to.
Well, Herschel Walker, I think his complaining right there about not being used to it, Dan, set up for his fellow competitors. He knows what he's doing.
A little bit of a con game, perhaps, but Herschel's been here before. He has experienced in the Superstars being a two-time winner.
That's Herschel Walker on the left of your screen in the green kayak. Again, this is an athletic event that requires being deliberate. You can't try to extend yourself and lose control.
Very smooth water for the competitors this morning, too.
Herschel Walker in the lead. A little struggle off to the right. Jake Reed changing lanes. Not exactly the quickest way to the finish line.
Oh, man, I'm done.
Herschel Walker, a comfortable lead over on the left side, and there's Herschel. Looks like he'll win this first heat rather easily. Unless he loses an oar here in the last couple of meters. He does not, and Herschel Walker, a very comfortable win here in heat number one. Jake Reed, the question here, will he finish?
Well, the question is will he stay afloat, and he did.
There's Cindy Walker, Herschel's wife, and she has seen that before.
Well, the key here for Herschel is he's just a machine. Very deliberate strokes, keeping the boat in perfect line between the buoys there for an easy win.
Well, in these heats, you're establishing a time. Right now, it's up to everybody else to chase Herschel Walker. Well, there are five other competitors in the kayaking that will compete in two more heats here in Montego Bay. So we'll find out what they have left in their oars. Before we see them, though, let's go back to New York and our Wide World of Sports studio and our host, Robin Roberts.
Hey, kayaking, kayaking.
Hello, man. A snappy little tune making its way up the charts. Hello again, everyone. Another full day here on ABC Sports. After the Superstars, we'll continue our coverage of the Hershey Kisses Figure Skating Challenge. You'll get to see Tara Lipinski in her first competition since bringing home the gold from Nagano, Japan. Also continuing today here in New York City at Madison Square Garden, the NFL Draft. It resumed with the fourth round today. And with the first pick in the fourth round, the Indianapolis Colts took Steve McKinney out of Texas A&M. Alonzo Mays, first-team All-America, led Oklahoma State in receptions and touchdowns. He fell in the draft because he tested positive for marijuana at the scouting combine. This draft continuing right now on ESPN2 if you want to catch any of this. Omar Brown, one of a record 30 defensive backs taken so far in this NFL draft. Kay Mays, would you believe the fifth North Carolina defensive player taken in four rounds? That's because the Tar Heels second in the nation in total defense last year, giving up just over 200 yards per game. Tim Dwight out of Iowa, the second player from Iowa to go here in the fourth round. And the final two picks in the fourth round, a pair of running backs, Curtis Alexander out of Alabama going to the Broncos, and Carlos King will be running the ball in Pittsburgh. And speaking of Pittsburgh, King will be taking handoffs from Cordell Stewart, who you will see in our Superstars competition a little bit later. He will hit the wings.
There he is, right there, in the water. Oh, good. He got over.
I'm on the green, but I'm not where I need to be, so better luck next time.
When I decided to train for this, I heard it all. Jehu, you fool, this is the desert. Jehu, it's 110 degrees, crazy things. I practice around 5-6 hours a day with the rumble pack. On the slopes, in the half pipe, Jehu is there. It's very spiritual. Just you and the mountain, and the snowboard, and the game.
1080 snowboarding only on Nintendo 64. Real close to the real thing.
I warn you, snowboarders, watch out for Jehu.
A tough case of athlete's foot can stop you in your tracks. You get that itching, the cracking, the burning. That's when you want a medicine and back stuff. Boom! Tough Actin Tenactin. It cures even tough cases of athlete's foot. Get Tough Actin Tenactin.
You thought it was over with, but you're still smoking. You keep trying to quit, but you keep lighting up. Zyban can help you look at quitting a whole new way. It's the nicotine in cigarettes that's addictive. It's been proven. And most people need help to quit. Today, there's nicotine-free Zyban. Not a patch. Not a gum. Instead, the first pill that is part of a comprehensive program from your doctor can help you quit smoking. Zyban is prescription medicine that can help reduce your urge to smoke and make quitting bearable. It's important to know there's a risk of seizure associated with Zyban. To reduce the risk, don't take Zyban if you've had an eating or seizure disorder or are being treated with Wellbutrin. Don't take Zyban if you're taking an MAO inhibitor. Quitting is tough, and Zyban won't work for everyone. See your doctor or pharmacist for information written especially for patients. Ask your doctor if Zyban is right for you. And break free from nicotine. Break free from smoking.
Get a tough case of athlete's foot and you're benched. You get that itching, the cracking, the burning. That's when you want a medicine that acts tough. Boom! Tough Actin Tenactin. It cures even tough cases of athlete's foot. Get Tough Actin Tenactin.
Nintendo Sports 25th Anniversary of the Superstars. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by Nintendo Sports. Tenactin. For tough cases of athlete's foot, there's Tough Actin Tenactin. The new Zip built-in drive from iOmega. Include one in your next computer. And Katera, the caddy that zigs.
It was the first year of Superstars, and Joe Frazier finding out it might have been easier to battle Ali than it was to take on the swimming pool. Competitors like Johnny Bench, Johnny Unitas, Jean-Claude Keeley. A lot of different events, table tennis, bowling, and even weightlifting. But in the end, we had to have a champion for that inaugural year. And the man who took home the medal was pole vaulter Bob Segrin.
Here stands Bob Segrin in a familiar situation with a gold medal around his neck.
Well, once again, the Superstars competition returns to the Caribbean. This time we've come to Montego Bay, Jamaica. The athletes arrive, and certainly guys like Cordell Stewart and Dorsey Levens, they've made the trip here to Jamaica to win. But I think it's safe to say at the same time they're here to have fun and to make some new memories.
Beautiful Jamaica. We're here for Nintendo Sports 25th Anniversary of the Superstars. Hi, everybody. I'm Dan Dierdorf alongside my partner, Dan Fouts. We've already seen one heat in the kayak event. We'll get back to that in just a couple of minutes. And Dan, over the last 25 years, I've really seen a lot of wonderful athletes and spirited competition here at the Superstars.
And really, we've just got a little bit of a taste of the great athletes that have performed here. And I think the thing comes out to, in my mind, Dan, is pride involved here. These guys are not concerned about the prize money. They go away from this event as the superstar for this year. Over the years, I've seen some great people. I have been at this one of the strongest we've ever seen.
There are a lot of young guys this year. Nine guys for the first time. Two former champions, Mike Powell and Herschel Walker, who's won twice.
Now, seven events take place during the course of this competition. A little bit about that.
Well, each athlete will choose seven of the 10 events, and here they are. We've already seen the kayaking. We have swimming, weightlifting, the 100-yard dash, jet skiing, the bicycle race, basketball, the half-mile run, golf closest to the pin, and of course, and your favorite, the obstacle course.
The points breakdown is as follows. 10 points for the winner, 7 for second, 4 for the third-place finisher, and then fourth gets 2, and the fifth-place guy gets 1 point.
And Dan, of course, raw athletic ability will play into this, but also experience. Remember, the winner gets $35,000.
Now, we're just a couple of broken down football guys. You know, we can't do an event without a sideline reporter. I think you know her best as Brenda from General Hospital. Working our sidelines is Vanessa Marcel. Hey, Vanessa.
Thank you, Dan. I have one of the toughest jobs in the world. I am hanging out in beautiful Jamaica with some of the top athletes in the world, and we are going to watch them play sports that we're not used to seeing them play, which means that they may not be quite as skilled as we're used to seeing them. We'll be seeing great football players kayaking. We'll be seeing track and field guys playing golf. The best part is we're going to take the helmets off these football players and expose their real personalities. We're also going to find out who is the real superstar. Take it away, Dan.
All right. Thank you, Vanessa. And let's check the results of the next couple of heats in the kayaking. In the second heat, freestyle gold medalist skier Johnny Mosley was an easy winner as he coasted home to victory. And then in heat number three, it was long jumper Mike Powell. Now, he was challenged here by Alan Johnson, who's on the right of your screen. Johnson loses control at the end, and in the green kayak, Mike Powell, with the best time, makes it to the finals. So the three competitors in lane number one, Johnny Mosley.
This is the life. This is the kind of competition that I like. Hanging out in the sun in Jamaica, racing a kayak.
Not bad. Here's lane number two, Mike Powell. You can see he's got an injury there on his left hand. He cut himself on a ceiling fan. He draws the middle lane. And Herschel Walker will be in lane number three.
And I get up.
Both Walker and Powell, of course, have competed in this event before, Dan, being former champions. But, you know, Mike Powell's got that cut on his left hand. That could be a factor.
Bob McAwee has them at the starting line, and we have a clean start. Herschel Walker on the far side in the red kayak. Mike Powell there in the middle in the green, and Johnny Mosley to the right in the blue. And Mosley gets off to a really solid start.
It appears that he is stroking twice as fast as the other athletes.
John Mosley really getting a good dig with that oar as he opens up a nice lead at the halfway point. Johnny Mosley very much under control. A relatively easy win here in the finals of the kayaking event.
And 10 big points.
Mike Powell came in second. And again, look at it one more time at how easily Johnny Mosley wins the kayak finals.
And what a surprise, his first event in the Superstars competition, and he wins it.
And that win is worth 10 points to this Olympic gold medalist. Mike Powell came in second. Herschel Walker picked up third. The two guys in fourth and fifth won it on times, even though they weren't in the finals, Lennox Lewis and Alan Johnson. And right now, Vanessa is with our competitors.
All right, here we are, and the winner is Johnny Mosley, drinking salt water. Did not let me down, did you?
I didn't. You know, I really wanted to do it for you. It was a great competition.
Yeah, it was. It was very cool. Mike, you almost went over.
Yeah, I started trying to get into John's stroke, trying to catch him, and I almost dumped it, so I had to let him go.
All right, Herschel. I think you kind of almost went over, too, didn't you?
Well, I did, but that's no excuse. I think Johnny was so far out there, going over may have helped me out. It wouldn't have been as embarrassing finishing over the table if I had gone over.
Well, one event is down. We've got nine to go, and Nintendo Sports' 25th anniversary of the Superstars will continue right after this.
One love.
Nothing slows Troy Aikman down. Not broken bones, herniated discs, crazed linemen, crazed women, MRIs, blurry eyes, black eyes, interceptions, interviews, bad reviews, pull-ups, push-ups, sit-ups, knee pain, back pain, head pain, big hits, high hits, low hits, late hits, frozen turf, soggy turf, astroturf, pull-downs, put-downs, fourth downs. But 3 to 4 times a day, he does stop for metrics. A nutrient-dense, high-octane food for people who never slow down, not even for this commercial.
Troy, come on, just one more take. Troy?
Hi, I'm Bob Carney, and we are one-on-one with Kobe Bryant. Kobe! Unbelievable game last night against the Knicks.
We ain't playing Knicks last
night. Let's take a look at the highlights. Whoa! What a move!
That was a nice move, man. That wasn't me, though.
How did you get so much air? You got up there, and you just had the ball, and 360, and woo! You were on fire!
Kobe Bryant in NBA courtside. All the moves, all the action, all the NBA you can jam in a game.
Wow. Let's have a moment of silence for the defense on that one.
Full-range traction control and speed-sensitive steering to help you avoid all those clowns out there. Katerra, the caddy that zigs.
Tonight, it's a national emergency when Wilfred L.'s first date is with the first daughter. My Date with the President's Daughter, ABC tonight at 7, 6 Central.
Heaven help Soul Man as he tries to juggle fatherhood and a social life.
I'll pick you up at 8.
Pick you up at 8, sweetheart.
You know, you're not too old for a spanking. No. Not you. Unless.
An all-new Soul Man between two home improvements. ABC Tuesday.
1977's competition had its share of thrills and spills. Hurdler Guy Drew didn't even make it over the hurdles at the end of the obstacle course. We had people like Tony Dorsett, Drew Pearson, Sugar Ray Leonard, and Steve Garvey. But actually, it was Kyle Roach Jr. 1977, the third out of 4 years that he won the coveted Superstars competition.
And it is Kyle Roach winning the swimming.
It's been a wonderful experience for all of us, and it's something we'll never forget. Thank you.
This year, the guys got their first chance to spend some time together at the pairings party. It's a night of a lot of fun, but some strategy involved. Each athlete must declare 7 events for the competition.
I'm not doing the weightlifting. Is that surprising?
I will not run the 100-yard dash because I'm afraid of them. So
I'm not doing the 100.
No, just kidding.
Well, the lineup cards are something the athletes take a little seriously. Well, most do.
I got tic-tac-toe.
Herschel plays a little tic-tac-toe on his. Well, the golf competition is next. The guys got a chance to warm up by testing their skills in a little pro-am tournament.
Beautiful. In the hole. Woo-hoo-hoo. Yes.
Isn't this the one here?
Yes.
Right there. There you go, right there. Tiger Woods starting out football would be a little bit different, you know? It's kind of like golf. With me, I couldn't even get on the same course with him. And in football, you know, if he's never played before, kind of difficult.
Well, I think I can ride.
Treat!
That's really good. It's just what the guy said to do.
Outstanding.
This is for all the marbles right here.
Oh, yes!
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Sweet!
Give it to him.
Woo!
Get your feel.
Let's check out my tan line. Pretty solid.
A reminder that coming up next, the Hershey Kisses Figure Skating Challenge. One dream team takes on another. Michelle Kwan and Michael Weiss against Nancy Kerrigan and Todd Eldridge next on ABC Sports. Well, we have a star-studded field for golf. The question is, can they play? Got guys like Cordell Stewart, Jake Reed, Keyshawn Johnson, J.J. Stokes, and Jason Sehorn. And the receivers think this thing's already in the bag.
We always go for the long ball.
Yeah, we always go for the long ball. I got to put myself in the receiver position.
I tell you what, I know one way we're going to win it. Just let Cordell pick the ball up, me and Keyshawn, and J.J. run out for a pass.
Yeah, just throw it.
Catch it, go.
You know, a DB's whole purpose of life is to steal thunder from the offense.
See, that side of the ball, I have no idea.
So
Hey, guys, you better add Johnny Mosley to the mix, and we're ready to go. Now, the rules are simple. The closest to the pin from 150 yards, you got to stay on the green, and each athlete will take 3 consecutive shots.
Oh, yeah!
Cordell Stewart was the first competitor, and on his third and final shot, Dan, a pretty good one.
Well, the wind is blowing very hard, and the green is very hard. Check out that bounce as he rolls it up very nicely.
Sorry, guys, I didn't mean to do that to y'all like that. Put the pressure on, but
you're a quarterback. That's
I think I just
bad.
Did.
Pressure indeed at 13 feet, 9.5 inches. The next 4 guys, they tried, but they didn't get it done. Keyshawn Johnson, he doesn't get it to stay on the green. And here's J.J. Stokes.
A lot of these shots just rolled right through the green because it's so hard.
Johnny Mosley, well, I think you can see not happy with that. And check out Jake Reed. Look out.
Hey, watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out.
Watch out is right. I think the term is 4, though, isn't it, Dan, when you throw your club that far?
I think Jake Reed taking a loose grip to the next level.
Somebody got a glove.
Hey, I'm not sure a glove's going to help that swing either.
Hey, that don't count, do it.
The ball closest to the not the club.
Wow. So, Cordell Stewart's early shot still holding up. The competition comes down to the final guy, and that's Jason Sehorn of the New York Giants.
With a 7-iron this time.
Yeah.
Too hard.
Next ball.
Jason hits our camera tower behind the green.
Too much club, too much wind, but a pretty good bullseye.
Going to have to give protective clothing to our crew. All right, Jason, this is his second of three.
Obviously changing clubs. Now this is the 8-iron.
Ooh, he pushes that ball a little bit right, and again, the fast green ushers that right into the bunker.
He's nervous right now. His heart is beating hard right now.
7-iron didn't work. The 8-iron didn't work. How about the 9?
There it is.
Online, online. Still rolling, still rolling. I'm on the green!
Okay, how it happened?
Well, that dribbler by Sehorn was good for second place and 7 points. Cordell's shot held up, good for 10. Four players share third and get 1¾ points. The overall standings, Johnny Mosley is in the lead with 11¾. Cordell Stewart in second with his 10 points, and then it's Mike Powell, Jason Sehorn, and Herschel Walker. And here's Vanessa.
The big winner is Cordell, as he actually predicted secretly to me before the game started. I'm kidding,
yes,
he didn't.
Did. kind of a little bit. I hinted just a tad bit, but I didn't want to sound too arrogant, so I kind of kept it pretty humble. I kind of looked at the field, and I scoped it out, and I watched him at the driving range, and I didn't feel that anyone had as much potential as I had, so I kind of fed off of that, and I hit the ball pretty decent, I suppose.
I'd say you did. This is the second event, so you have a lot left to go, so save up your energy. I'm rooting for you. I'm here for you.
Appreciate it. I'm waiting for you, babe.
Aww.
Well, even the kids turned out here in Montego Bay to watch the superstars. What they're going to see next is weightlifting.
When I decided to train for this, I heard it all. Jehu, you fool, this is a desert. Jehu, it's 110 degrees, crazy things. I practice around 5-6 hours a day with the rumble pack. On the slopes, in the half pipe, Jehu is there. It's very spiritual. Just you and the mountain, and the snowboard, and the game.
1080 snowboarding only on Nintendo 64. Real close to the real thing.
I warn you, snowboarders, watch out for Jehu.
Suspension and full range traction control. And while these features may seem somewhat dry on paper, drivers find them quite inspiring on other surfaces. Katerra, the caddy that zigs.
Oh! You're supposed to get wet, it's Jamaica.
Next Sunday on ABC Sports at 1 Eastern, 12 Pacific, it's the Talladega 500, NASCAR's finest. Take on the big track in Talladega next Sunday on ABC. Well, 25 years of memories. A generation that grew up watching the superstars. Hey, guys, any memories?
Willie Galt, Ronaldo Nehemiah. You know, and I always thought, wow, I could do some of that stuff. But I never thought I'd have a chance to do it.
For the most part, I remember like Ronaldo Nehemiah and Roger Kingdom. And the biggest thing I remember is the obstacle course.
Herschel Walker, winning it like 10 years ago.
Watching Herschel Walker run through an obstacle course, you know, and it looks so fun, it looks so cool, like such a great thing to do. The
the memories that I have are mostly of Herschel Winning and Mike Powell. These are two guys that I can remember watching when I was growing up.
Well, I remember watching it and hoping, say, I wish I could do that. You know, you sit at home just saying, I wish I can do it. I wish I can do that there. And, you know, never having an idea that you'll have a chance to do it.
The Superstar.
Our third event is weightlifting. The starting weight is 200 pounds. We'll go up in increments of 20 pounds, and only five competitors are entered. It's the smallest field ever, and everybody gets at least 1 point.
Gotta have a clown here somewhere.
Well, we start at 200 pounds, Dan, and everybody makes it.
And everybody's worried about one guy, and that's Herschel Walker. You know, I wonder how much that cut hand of Mike Powell's affected him today.
Well, he's a long jumper by trade. I think he's letting everybody know weightlifting, not his strong suit.
Well, one of the strongest wide receivers in the NFL, Jake Reed, has no problem at 200 pounds.
Next up, Keyshawn Johnson of the New York Jets. And he snaps it up there with ease.
Keyshawn!
Come on!
I aim your weight.
And from the Green Bay Packers, Dorsey Levens, and with his upper body strength, with ease.
From the Dallas Cowboys, Herschel Walker.
I just want to go to 260.
And a guy with some pretty good upper body strength himself, Herschel Walker. 200 pounds should be easy for him.
You haven't been lifting no weight.
I don't do no weight. Hey, remember, I'm from the country. Hey, I cut wood.
You still use it. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They're not buying it, Herschel. We move now to 220 pounds. Mike Powell's up first, and he doesn't get it.
Not bad for a long jumper.
Not bad when you look at that 1 point he's guaranteed.
Well, the rest of the field made it at 220 and 240. We moved down to 260 pounds. Heavyweight champ Lennox Lewis looks on. He's got sore hands. Didn't participate because of his recent bout with Shannon Briggs. Jake Reed, the first at 260.
And he doesn't quite get his arms fully extended, so it's no lift.
Keyshawn Johnson, next up. Ooh, and he doesn't even come close.
A couple wide receivers bite the dust.
Herschel Walker and Dorsey Levens both make it at 260 and 280. And that means we move to 300 pounds. Dorsey Levens is first.
Dorsey using his legs to help power that weight over his head.
And Commissioner Bob McAlee says it was good.
I never said I didn't lift.
Oh, okay.
I never said that.
Well, that's not the Walker that Levens is competing against. It's this Walker.
Contrasting styles for Herschel Walker as he primarily will use his upper body to push this 300 pounds.
And Herschel Walker clears the 300 pounds. Dorsey Levens on the sidelines. Oh, no. We've got to move up. And move up you do to 320 pounds, where Dorsey Levens goes first. Oh, and he doesn't get it, doesn't come close. That leaves the weightlifting event to Herschel Walker. Dan, it's his to win.
Oh, he's been a tremendously gifted and well-conditioned athlete, Dan, 36 years old, Herschel Walker. No hesitation either.
Boy, he's talking to it. And he does it. Herschel Walker gets the whistle from Bob McAlee, and he wins the weightlifting event at 320. So Herschel Walker picks up 10 points for the win. Dorsey gets 7 for second. Keyshawn and Jake tied for third. They get 3 points each, and Mike Powell picks up a single.
Dorsey pushed me. Tell you what, this Georgia Tech guy and this Georgia boy here, we had to show that we got some muscles with us.
Oh yeah, oh yeah. My hat goes off to you, my man.
Oh, thank you. I thought you were going to give me the hat.
No, but you have the lead, Herschel, after three events with 14 points. Mosley and Stewart, Powell, Levins, and Seahorn round out the top six. We'll be back with more superstars after this message and a word from our ABC station.
Hi, I'm Bob Carney, and we are one-on-one with Kobe Bryant. Kobe, unbelievable game last night against the Knicks.
We ain't playing Knicks last
night. Let's take a look at the highlights. Whoa, what a move.
That was a nice move, man. That wasn't me, though.
How did you get so much air? You got up there, and you just had the ball, and 360, and woo! You were on fire.
Kobe Bryant in NBA courtside. All the moves, all the action, all the NBA you can jam in a game.
Wow. Let's have a moment of silence for the defense on that one.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are flying in the Bermuda Triangle, a place where things are known to disappear and are never found. Now, fortunately, we have an iOmega Zip Drive on board, and with it I can make a quick copy of all my important stuff.
The 100 megabyte zip disk let me save, store, and take all my stuff with me.
No need to panic. Okay, boys, let's take her back in. Hello?
Get an iOmega Zip Drive today, because it's your stuff. This is Major Tom to ground control. I'm
stepping through the door. Houston, we have a problem. Tell my wife
I love her very much. The Apollo 13 astronauts may be in grave danger.
Apollo 13, next Sunday on ABC.
Jane, my vision of healthcare lives in my head.
What about the benefits a business can expect?
The benefits are big, I tell you. Big.
Can a business expect savings and service or claims taken care of promptly?
Prompt is such a relative term.
Call and find out about HIP, the not-for-profit company with over 50 years of experience. Call HIP or your broker and receive a free brochure on our business health plans and a 10-minute long-distance calling card.
How long has your company been in operation?
I'm really not sure. We've just met.
So, where do you get your healthcare?
It's HIP.
Did you know every day more and more individuals and families save up to 50% on their dental bills thanks to the prestigious Northeast Dental Plan of America? It's a cooperative of more than 3,500 dentists in your area. The annual membership of only $85 entitles you to huge discounts on all dental work, including substantial discounts on cleanings and x-rays. There's even a free examination. Call now for your free complete information kit.
Israel at 15, a special report Monday at 6.
You're watching Nintendo Sports 25th Anniversary of the Superstars on ABC Sports. In 1982, defending champion Ronaldo Nehemiah took the Superstars title again. And with shots like that, not much of a surprise.
He cannot afford penalties. Collinsworth now coming back at Nehemiah. Gates does not hurdle the high bar, but how about...
A convincing win in the obstacle course for Nehemiah, but I think 82 will best be remembered for this frightening bike collision right here between Mark Castaneau and Bob Seagrip. Well, this year our visit allowed us to enjoy Montego Bay and its many pleasures. The beauty of Doctor's Cave Beach with all of its activities. The grandeur of Rose Hall Great House, haunted by the ghost of Annie Palmer, and a chance to sample all the beautiful local crafts.
Welcome to Montego Bay. I'd like to see you here.
Well, Montego Bay certainly has been a lot of fun, and right now, we're going to move over to Half Moon Bay, where swimming is next. We've got to find out the rules for this event. Let's get them with a local player.
Swimming in the Jamaican Ocean.
Three lanes.
It's a running start.
It's a freestyle.
Hey man, you got to go around the buoy.
race is 75 yards long. No problem.
Stop 3 times, make the final.
Unbelievable. This is a race to the finish.
We will have 2 preliminary heats here in the swimming competition. Remember, the top 3 times make it to the finals. Now in heat number 1, Jason Seahorn defeated Dorsey Levins and Cordell Stewart, and he established the time to beat here in the prelims of 51.67. A rather leisurely stroll to the line for Seahorn. So the second heat is a 2-man heat. Alan Johnson and Johnny Mosley.
Looks is what it's all about. You know what I'm saying? It's not how well you do, it's how good you looked when you did it. You know what I mean? Especially in Jamaica, everybody looking good.
All right, Johnny, come on, both of you come right up on these 2 girls.
You'd expect Alan Johnson to get a quick start as we run to the water.
You're out of here. Bob McAlee gets these guys going, and you're right, Alan Johnson, the first into the bay.
Now, this is a 75-yard race, so halfway down. The toughest part of this race is going around the buoy, Dan. There's no wall to kick off here.
2 swimmers just about even as they get set to make this turn. Oh, and Johnny Mosley, much more efficient, Dan, as he gets around that buoy.
He didn't stop stroking the whole way around the buoy. But watch now, as it appears that both of them are going to use up their entire lanes.
Oh, and this is where it starts to burn a little bit. Alan Johnson gets tangled up in the lane marker. That cost him some time. Johnny Mosley getting his legs underneath him as he makes a run to the finish line. And he dives across and does a face-first landing.
That's hardcore. I'm not sure I want to do that again.
Here's the key to the race, Dan. See, Alan Johnson lost his goggles on the dive and had to take a peek to see where he was around that buoy.
And another look at Johnny Mosley. Big air.
That's a face plant. That's the, I don't know, I can't think right now. That's what that is. That's called the no thinker.
Well, you better start thinking about the finals, because the top 5 times, Seahorn, Mosley, and Levins will be in the final. Johnson and Stewart get 4th and 5th because there are only 5 competitors. So the 3 men eye the swimming final, which is coming up right after this.
W1 by Raymond Weil. The cutting edge in time. Time for the next generation. W1 by Raymond Weil.
When I decided to train for this, I heard it all. Jehu, you fool, this is the desert. Jehu, it's 110 degrees, crazy things. I practice around 5-6 hours a day with the rumble pack. On the slopes, in the half pipe, Jehu is there. It's very spiritual. Just you and the mountain. And the snowboard. And the game.
1080 snowboarding only on Nintendo 64. Real close to the real thing.
I warn you, snowboarders, watch out for Jehu.
The Money Store will now lend you more than the market value of your home with 1 low first mortgage rate. At other lenders, you can end up having 2 loans, a first mortgage and a high rate second. But with the Money Store's no equity refi loan, you have just 1 loan at their low first mortgage rate to cut expenses, pay off credit cards, even get some extra cash. So call 1-800-LOAN-YES-NOW and ask for the no equity refi loan, only at the Money Store.
Tonight, a world premiere. A happily married couple. A troubled child. They turn to a professional.
You think we really could be the problem?
But she turned on them.
I slept with her, Hannah.
1 session at a time.
She's used every secret against us like a weapon.
Mind Games, ABC Tonight.
Monday, the threat of nuclear war is still real. Russia's economy is weak, security systems unstable. A mistake could happen. It almost did on World News Tonight.
Well, it was 11 years ago in Miami, Florida, 1987, and the Herschel Walker Superstars era officially begins. Herschel won his first title back in 1987, but it also was the year that started a real classic rivalry in Superstars competition, Herschel and fellow NFLer Willie Gault. In 87, Herschel squeaked out a 1.5-point win over Gault.
I give a lot of respect to swimmers. That is too much on the heart. I might have a coronary halfway through this thing. Jeez.
Oh. Cheers. Hey, man. Cien, bro. It's sweet. I'm just happy to be here.
Whether in the air or on the beach, Olympic gold medalist Johnny Mosley has the right attitude. Golden Nagano created a whole new world for this 22-year-old.
All these opportunities and great things are in front of me now, so I'm able to just enjoy life a lot right now because I have accomplished something that meant a lot to me, which is the gold medal, and then things have just been rosy since then.
There have been parades in his honor, and he is soaking it in. He even threw out the first pitch for his hometown Giants. Here's a guy who's comfortable with his celebrity status, and here in Jamaica, it's obvious he's having the time of his life.
To be the superstar of superstars, that would be awesome.
Well, it is time for the swimming final. The lane assignments, Johnny Mosley on the near side in lane one, Jason Seahorn in the middle, and on the far side, lane three, Dorsey Levins. Bob McElwee gets them started, a clean start in there, into the water and underway.
And this is the most grueling event of all 10 events in the Superstars. Remember how tired these guys were after the preliminary event. We'll see how much they have left here in the finals.
Right now, it's a two-man race between Mosley and Seahorn as they come to the buoy.
Seahorn using just his left arm to propel himself around that buoy. And he keeps his head in the water the entire race, just coming up to breathe while Mosley has his head out of the water most of the race.
Jason Seahorn, oh, he begins to wander off to the right and goes across the lane marker. Centers himself. And now he's coming this direction. Jason Seahorn in the lead, but all over the place.
Well, fatigue really affected him there, but he had a big lead.
Well, strong enough to go ahead and win it is Jason Seahorn, and he's whipped. Johnny Mosley comes in second. Dorsey Levins will get third.
No mas.
Vanessa, get with the winner, will you?
You said that you were not sure if you could do it again, and you just did it.
Those ropes kind of got my way, though. That was a distraction.
Yeah, they slowed you down for 1 second, but you still did it.
Got to fight out of it. My goodness, I've never done anything that exhausting in my life.
Whew. Isn't it great to try and talk right now?
Oh, my gosh. I'm doing my best. Man.
Well, that win by Jason Seahorn was good for 10 points. Johnny Mosley second, Levin third, Alan Johnson fourth, and Cordell Stewart picks up a point for fifth. So overall, after four events, Johnny Mosley is our leader now with 18.75 points, followed by Seahorn, Walker, Levin, Stewart, and Powell.
It was great. I taught him everything. Except that running into the buoy. I didn't teach him that.
A tough case of athlete's foot can stop you in your tracks. You get that itching, the cracking, the burning. That's when you want a medicine and act stuff. Boom! Tough Actin Tenactin. It cures even tough cases of athlete's foot. Get Tough Actin Tenactin.
Nothing slows Troy Aikman down. Not broken bones, herniated discs, crazed linemen, crazed women, MRIs, blurry eyes, black eyes, interceptions, interviews, bad reviews, pull-ups, push-ups, sit-ups, knee pain, back pain, head pain, big hits, high hits, low hits, late hits, frozen turf, soggy turf, astroturf, pull-downs, put-downs, fourth downs. But 3 to 4 times a day, he does stop for metrics. A nutrient-dense, high-octane food for people who never slow down. Not even for this commercial.
Troy, come on! Just one more take!
Hi, I'm Jim Palmer. Right now, first mortgage rates are lower than they've been in years. It's a great time to refinance, but some lenders can keep you waiting for weeks. And that means you could miss out on major savings, but you don't have to. Call the Money Store. They'll take your application over the phone with no waiting. So don't take chances. If you're a homeowner, call 1-800-LOAN-YES now, even if you have less than perfect credit. The Money Store, where America goes for money.
Get a tough case of athlete's foot and you're benched. You get that itching, the cracking, the burning. That's when you want a medicine at Axe Tough. Boom! Tough Actin Tenactin. It cures even tough cases of athlete's foot. Get Tough Actin Tenactin.
Well, so far, 4 events are in the books, and as you can tell, the intensity level is starting to pick up. And for a midday break, the competitors decide to gather on the beach for a little informal tug-of-war. We're going to call this the Tough Actin Tenactin tug-of-war. 4 guys on each side, Dan.
And something that I know you always like to do to break the tension, Dan, get into a little friendly tug-of-war.
Well, you know, the bigger you are, the easier this is. Traction is at a premium here on the beach.
But it also pays to negotiate well. And maybe find yourself a wild card.
Well, there's 4 on each side, as I said, but we're about to have a wild card, and there he is. Mike Powell comes in, gives a little extra help to the one side, and they end up winning.
And next, from Montego Bay, is basketball.
60 seconds to shoot. All right. 0-5 shooting here, you know what I'm saying, man?
If a player
converts a basket,
he may not take his next shot.
From the same area.
Head to head in the first round.
4 players advance to the final.
Okay, here's how the scoring goes. 1 point for a layup. 2 points for basically a 10-foot jump shot. And the rest I'll let J.T. Stokes explain.
Then you come to me from the free throw line extended for the 3-pointer and the big money shots. You come to the 4-pointer for the top of the key. And then you come to the 5, which is a 3-point line.
Wow. I need some work.
All right, first of all, we got Stokes and Stewart. The thing to keep in mind here, even though they're out there 2 at a time, it is the top 4 point totals that make it to the finals. JJ comes through here with 28, Cordell 23. Next, we've got Walker and Levins, and Dorsey Levins really shows a sweet touch from the outside. He knocks down 30, Herschel got 25. All right, Johnson and Powell. Keyshawn comes in with 24. Mike Powell struggled in a very physical contest. He only had 20. And Johnny Mosley and Alan Johnson, the key here is that Mosley needed 24 points to make the final. He was only able to score 23. So the prelim results have Levin, Stokes, Walker, and Johnson going to the finals where they'll start over. Stewart and Mosley split a point at 5th. Let's move now to the basketball finals. The first pairing is J.J. Stokes and Herschel Walker, and they'll go for 60 seconds.
And you can hear the music in the background. They will play for 60 seconds, kind of like musical baskets. When they stop, competition's over.
The key here is you cannot make a basket twice in a row from the same place on the court. So if you make one up close, you've got to leave close range and go back and try something a little farther out.
Well, you see, both Herschel and JJ are majoring in the 1 and 2 pointers here. The other school of thought is to go back and try the 5- and 4-pointers. Of course, they're a little bit harder.
The tough part of that, Dan, is you sometimes get a bad carom off of that rim, and losing track of your basketball and having it leave the court costs you an awful lot of time.
JJ's left-handed, but he also has the ability to use his right hand. That's a key as well.
Well, a really soft touch for JJ Stokes. The countdown here, the final seconds, and they go out for long range.
2, 1.
Oh, and J.J. Stokes hits a 5-pointer in the last second. Comes in with 28 points for J.J. Stokes. Herschel Walker with 27. And what a way to finish.
Shows you just how important this 3-pointer is, but this time it's a 5-pointer.
Okay, JJ, you got 28, so you've still got the score to beat.
Yes, hopefully they'll have a couple misses and allow me to win it. But I was rusty at the beginning, and I came on strong at the end. So fortunately for me, that happened.
Yeah, you definitely came on strong at the end. And I would have to say that this would be your territory.
Oh, definitely. That last five hit it off for me. And it's that smooth stroke from UCLA.
Superstar. Well, in the other finals here in the basketball competition, Green Bay Packers running back Dorsey Levens gets ready to go. What a great year he had in 1997, 1,435 yards rushing, 7 touchdowns. He had 5 touchdowns receiving in his first year of really being the main guy.
3, 2, 1.
Looks like both guys are going to try the long shots first. Keyshawn gets his, and so does Levens.
Point here to be made. J.J. Stokes in the other final set the mark at 28 points. That's what these two are chasing.
And you notice that Levens is majoring more in the long shots. Keyshawn steps back this time and drills that one.
Well, Dorsey was hurt there, Dan. He had an air ball that left the court, and he didn't shoot for at least 5 seconds.
Yeah, he's going to have to just start putting up the long ones now.
Dorsey Levens does head to the outside. Oh, and he knocks down a 5-pointer. Now, again, he's not allowed to do that. He went back. If he would have made that shot, it would not have counted.
And remember, when the music stops, so does the competition.
A lot of work inside being done by Keyshawn Johnson inside the final 10 seconds. Oh, and Dorsey Levens ties it with that one. He only needs a 1-pointer, but he goes all the way back out, and with his foot on the line, hits a 4-pointer to win the competition with 32 points. Dorsey Levens took a real chance by going all the way out, but he made it. To tie the competition, Dan, boy, what a sweet stroke.
With no scoreboard out here, Dan, he felt he had to go deep to get more points.
There is the points breakdown for the basketball event. Dorsey Levens picks up 10. And at the halfway point, that gives Dorsey the lead with 21 points. The key here, though, for Levens and Mosley, they only have 3 events remaining. The bicycle race is coming up after this message and a word from our ABC station.
I doth trashed it.
If you have an iOmega zip drive, your family can keep track of everything.
I downloaded some military school information. You seen it?
What?
So make copies of all your stuff on 100 megabyte zip disks, so nothing gets lost. Almost.
Hello? Anyone see my retainer?
Get an iOmega zip drive today, because it's your stuff.
Something's out there.
This thing's part human.
Waiting.
Don't expect it to stop at the water's edge.
So horrible.
You go after that thing. You're insane.
So terrifying.
Get your people out of here now!
It will make you scream. Peter Benchley's Creature, ABC May. Now you're not safe anywhere.
There's a big cover-up performed by millions of people every day. People who have ugly nail fungus. It turns nails colors, makes them thick or brittle. But now you may be able to go barefoot without embarrassment. With more beautiful nails, healthier, clearer nails. You see, nail fungus lives deep under the nail at the base. That's why it's so hard to get rid of. But by calling this number now, you'll receive a free video and learn how it may be possible to get beautiful, healthy nails back. Because today, your doctor has effective treatments that attack the fungus right where it lives. So call to uncover the truth about nail fungus and get your free video on nail care and treatments. The sooner you call, the sooner you may be able to go barefoot without embarrassment.
Rob Hanrahan, Channel 7 Eyewitness News. From ABC's Wide World of Sports studio in New York, here's Robin Roberts.
Still to come, figure skating, and after this Wide World of Sports update, we'll return for more Superstars competition where Dorsey Levens is leading after five events. And speaking of football, of course, the NFL draft is continuing today here in New York City. The fifth round is not complete, and with the first pick in the fifth round, Cecil, you can call me Martin Chase, the pick of the Baltimore Ravens. Robert Williams, the sixth defender from the second-ranked defense in the nation, the North Carolina Tar Heels, going to Kansas City. And also on offense, North Carolina, their running back, Jonathan Linton, 1,000 yards rushing last season, is headed to the Buffalo Bills. Wilmont Perry, Division II record of 9.1 yards rushing last season, goes to the Saints. ESPN2 is continuing the coverage of the NFL draft. All seven rounds, 229 picks that you will see today. The number 23 pick in the fifth round, Blake Spence, maybe Keyshawn Johnson will get some help. He averaged 16.6 yards a catch last year for Oregon. And as they did in the fourth round, the Denver Broncos going with a running back again here in the fifth round, Chris Howard out of Michigan. Don't forget later, we'll continue our coverage of the Hershey Kisses Figure Skating Challenge, Tara Lipinski's first action since bringing home Olympic gold. For more now, let's check in with Brent Musburger.
Robin, this is the featured event in the Hershey's Kisses Figure Skating Challenge, our team format, because today we're going to be watching Tara Lipinski compete for the first time as a professional. It will be her long program, but remember, she's not competing against Michelle Kwan as an individual here today. No, it is a dream team competition. You'll also be seeing Nicole Bobek, Victor Petrenko, and Rudy Galindo. Should be special, Robin.
And it should be fun. Speaking of fun, back to Jamaica and Dan Dierdorf. We'll see you later.
Welcome to beautiful Jamaica, everybody. We're here for the Nintendo Sports 25th anniversary of the Superstars.
It's time to go downtown. Here's Vanessa.
Hi, Dan. As you just mentioned, we are now in beautiful downtown Montego Bay. It is one of the most popular cruise ship destinations, and thousands of tourists come here every day. But today, tourists are going to become spectators because we have the power to shut this town down, and we're going to do it for the bike race and the half-mile run right now. One bike day.
Dorsey Levens has a 1 3/4 points lead right now over Johnny Mosley.
Well, at the halfway point, the leaders are pretty much bunched together. As for the second events, we move here to downtown Montego Bay. And Dan, the thing I think that looks critical to me right now is who has how many events left. I think this is going to be critical.
Well, Levens and Mosley only have three events left. Herschel Walker has four. The key, though, is Jason Seahorn got 17 points in just two events. So he's got five events to go through today. So the key, obviously, will be fatigue, perhaps, with the obstacle course being the last event.
But Jason, one thing going in his favor, he is young. And right now, we move to the bicycling.
Well, we're set to start the bicycle race in downtown Montego Bay. A lot of excitement at the start line, and our new guy, Keyshawn Johnson, has found Jake Reed.
You know, I haven't rode a bike since high school, but I think once you learn, you never forget. So I'm all out today. I got my elbow pads on, knee pads, my biking tights. I'm looking like a professional, baby. I'm ready to go.
Well, it's a little bit different today because it's a mile and a half, and we were kids. We ran around in the dirt and little dirt bikes, so this is a new experience for us.
Well, I tell you what, though. Like I told my wife, I don't think any other guys out here been riding bikes either. They've been riding around in Mercedes-Benz just like me, so I got an equal chance, too.
That was Jake Reed of the Minnesota Vikings. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Keyshawn. Good work with the microphone. And I think we all remember Keyshawn Johnson when he was the first overall pick in the NFL draft back in 1996. A strong performance last year, his best year yet with the New York Jets at wide receiver. And in his spare time, here's a guy that likes to sit down and pretend he's Big Air Johnny Mosley, working a little video game action. And Dan Fouts, I know you remember the book that Keyshawn wrote.
Yeah, wasn't it called Just Throw Me the Damn Ball or something? I'm sure there's a lot of quarterbacks out there that would like to write a book that said, hey, shut up and catch the ball.
Well, Keyshawn Johnson certainly didn't duck that controversy. A stand-up guy and says, I am who I am. Like me or leave me, I don't care.
And he's pretty good at Nintendo. But you know what, Dan? I'd like to see him take on my 7-year-old Ryan.
Well, what he has to do right now is get ready for the bike race. It's 1.2 miles. 8 athletes are in it. It's the 6th event of the competition. And Dorsey Levins, our leader, is going to sit this one out. It was a very good start by Keyshawn Johnson. He broke from the field and opened up an early lead. Now, Jason Seahorn did a nice job of staying right behind Johnson, not letting him get too big of a lead, and Johnny Mosley stayed right with Seahorn and the lead pack.
And we see how Seahorn now is breaking the air for Mosley. Lennox Lewis took the lead briefly right there as they hit the hip strip, but with a half mile to go, Seahorn was in command. Until this impressive move by Alan Johnson, as he puts on a burst of energy right there, takes the lead momentarily from Seahorn. But he appears to run out of gas, and Seahorn regains the lead, and it's on to the finish line.
And much as he did in the swimming competition down the stretch, I think just the raw strength of Jason Seahorn, too much for the other competitors, an easy win in the bicycle. Mosley got 7 points per second. It was then Stokes, Johnson, and Lewis. So in the overall standings after 6 events, both Seahorn and Mosley move ahead of the idle Dorsey Levins, a 3/4 point lead for Jason Seahorn.
And that mile and a half is a long race.
Tough case of athlete's foot can stop you in your tracks.
You get that itching, the cracking, the burning.
That's when you want a medicine and back stuff. Boom! Tough Actin Tenactin. It cures even tough cases of athlete's foot. Get Tough Actin Tenactin.
When I decided to train for this, I heard it all. Jehu, you fool, this is the desert. Jehu, it's 110 degrees, crazy things. I practice around 5-6 hours a day with the rumble pack. On the slopes, in the half pipe, Jehu is there. It's very spiritual. Just you and the mountain, and the snowboard, and the game.
1080 snowboarding only on Nintendo 64. Real close to the real thing.
I warn you, snowboarders, watch out for Jehu.
The Money Store will now lend you more than the market value of your home with one low first mortgage rate. At other lenders, you can end up having two loans, a first mortgage and a high rate second. But with the Money Store's no equity refi loan, you have just one loan at their low first mortgage rate to cut expenses, pay off credit cards, even get some extra cash. So call 1-800-LOAN-YES now and ask for the no equity refi loan, only at the Money Store.
Get a tough case of athlete's foot and you're benched.
You get that itching, the cracking, the burning.
That's when you want a medicine at Act Tough. Boom! Tough Actin Tenactin. It cures even tough cases of athlete's foot. Get Tough Actin Tenactin.
The
Nintendo Sports 25th Anniversary of the Superstars. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by Nintendo Sports. Tenactin. For tough cases of athlete's foot, there's Tough Actin Tenactin. The new Zip built-in drive from iOmega. Include one in your next computer. And Katera, the caddy that zigs.
I wanna leave this town, this place. I'm tired of people laughing in my face. I gotta get away,
gotta get away.
I gotta get away to a better place. Well, all right.
Well, time to put those bicycles aside and hoof it. It's time for the half-mile run, our seventh event. We're going to stay right downtown on the streets of Montego Bay. Heading down the home stretch is Vanessa.
Okay, we're moments away from the start of this race. We have Herschel Walker. Herschel, it is very hot outside, and it looks like you have some very stiff competition.
I tell you what, there's a lot of stiff competition, and this is not my race here. But I'm just trying to run. Maybe I can get in the draft of someone and make it in.
Well, we'll be here watching.
Thank you. I just want to finish.
Superstar is a competitor that competes at his best at every event. You know, he, no matter what he's in, golf to jet skiing, he's going to give it 110%.
Herschel won the Superstars competition in 87 and 88, and now at age 36, you know one thing for sure, he is never satisfied.
I think the advantage I have is I know just how to go into an event. You know, I just know how when you go into it, you give it your hardest, you give it your best shot.
Well, Herschel's at the start line for the beginning of the half-mile run. 9 of the 11 competitors are going to take place. Mosley and Levins are not. Remember, they're in second and third place.
I'm with you.
My block's ready.
Oh. A punch in your nose, man.
Well, when Lennox Lewis shakes a fist at you, you better get concerned. And the seriousness of what's ahead in a half-mile run shows on the face of the field.
Again, it's important for the competitors to really conserve their energy and hopefully have enough for a sprint to the finish line.
This is a little, I think, inappropriate that a quarterback and an offensive lineman are calling a half-mile run. It's been a long time since either one of us saw that kind of a distance.
And you notice on the right side, that's Alan Johnson. J.J. Stokes right in the middle. I think Alan Johnson's got a lot of experience in this type of race.
Herschel Walker there on the left of your screen. As at least, and there's Lennox Lewis, who actually puts on a mini burst and moves out in front. Certainly the largest man in the field carrying the most weight, but certainly we all know how much road work boxers do.
And a real local favorite here in Montego Bay and throughout Jamaica.
Again, the look over the shoulder by Lennox Lewis as he moves all the way over as the field follows him as they move over to the other lane. The streets of downtown Montego Bay shut down for this and the bicycle race which preceded it.
It's anybody's race so far.
There's a lot of movement going on as we're starting to see the first signs of the pack starting to open up. Got a lead group of about six runners that have moved out and separated themselves from the field a bit. Jason Seahorn with his hat on backwards. And there's Alan Johnson now as he is the first to make his move to the far side of the street. Herschel Walker with a very slight lead.
And when you look at Seahorn, Walker, and Cordell Stewart out front there, the younger two guys, Seahorn and Stewart, seem to be running a little bit looser, a little bit more under control.
The lead group moves over to the far side of the street as they get set for the finish. About 200 yards to go.
And about time for one of them to make a move. And watch Alan Johnson in the blue shirt. And now Seahorn on the right side of the screen. Johnson looks over his right shoulder, and Seahorn busts the tape.
Alan Johnson, so preoccupied with looking to his competition to the right, didn't appear to be aware of the fact that Jason Seahorn was passing him on the other side. Jake Reed in the tail end of the field makes its way across the finish line.
You're absolutely right, Dan. I think that Johnson was looking more at Herschel Walker. Seahorn comes up on his left side and goes right by him. Watch Johnson look to the right to find out where Herschel is. Hey, what about Jason?
Hey, Vanessa, some stories here. What's going on down at the finish line?
Okay, I'm here with Alan Johnson. We just finished the half-mile race, and I have to tell you that I thought you were winning. I thought you were going to win at the end there, and you looked off to the side. Can you tell us what happened?
Yeah, you know, I came down. I was watching Herschel. Once we came around the corner, Herschel took off, and I figured, well, I better go now. I got in front of him where what I thought was comfortable, so I looked to the right, and I saw that he wasn't coming on me anymore. So I thought I had it won, and at the last minute, Seahorn comes by and takes the race. I guess that goes to show you got to run all the way to the finish line.
Absolutely. Great strategy and a little bit of a surprise for Jason Seahorn as he goes by Alan Johnson.
Jason Seahorn puts a little more money in the bank, and he's with Vanessa.
Okay, I'm here with Jason, and I have to tell you that we all kind of thought Alan was going to win there for a second. You kind of showed up out of nowhere. What happened?
And I saw him running down towards the finish line, and I saw him holding off Herschel. I don't think he really saw me coming the outside, and towards the finish line, he kind of started to ease up a little bit, and I was giving everything God gave me, and you know, thank God I was able to get across.
Right, so what's the moral of the story?
Don't give up till you get to the finish line.
That's right.
That win worth 10 points for Jason Seahorn. Alan Johnson came in second. Then it was Herschel Walker, Stewart, and Keyshawn Johnson. After seven events, Jason Seahorn starting to open up a lead with 37 points. Then it's Mosley Walker, Levin Stewart, and J.J. Stokes. Sports a very big part of the way of life down here in Jamaica, and they're very proud of the Reggae Boys. Their World Cup soccer team qualifies for competition in France later this summer.
Hi, I'm Bob Carney, and we are one-on-one with Kobe Bryant. Kobe, unbelievable game last night against the Knicks.
We ain't playing Knicks last
night. Let's take a look at the highlights. Whoa! What a move!
That was a nice move, man. That wasn't me, though.
How did you get so much air? You got up there and you just had the ball, 360, and woo! You were on fire!
Kobe Bryant in NBA courtside. All the moves, all the action, all the NBA you can jam in a game.
Wow. Let's have a moment of silence for the defense on that one.
I need more people out here. This is a big bird.
35,000 cubic feet of storage space, room for six city buses. The Condor is the world's largest cargo plane, yet it's nothing compared to the unlimited capacity you get with this amazing drive. The Zip built in. Get one in your next computer from iOmega.
Hey, you need a hand with that?
Get away.
Full-range traction control and speed-sensitive steering to help you avoid all those clowns out there. Katerra, the caddy that zigs.
Do you like America's Funniest Home Videos?
Oh, yeah, I do.
It's hilarious. I love that show. The Daisy Woodface.
Hubba hubba.
So, do you know when it's on?
Monday.
You're right. AFB is coming back home to ABC Monday. I assume you'll be tuning in. America's Funniest Home Videos, ABC.
Monday, Monday,
right.
Monday.
Best time to commit a crime in New York City? Tuesday at 10 p.m.
Welcome back to beautiful Montego Bay, Nintendo Sports 25th anniversary of the Superstars. A reminder, the next Saturday at 2 o'clock Eastern, 3 Pacific on ABC Sports, some of the great soccer players in the world will be on hand when the New York, New Jersey Metro Stars take on the San Jose Clash next Saturday right here on ABC Sports. 10 years ago in 1988, a lot of records were set. Reggie White just shattered the weightlifting record. It still stands. In the bicycle race, Ronaldo Nehemiah set a new Superstars record as he went around the track. But it was the consistent performance of one Herschel Walker. Here winning the 100-yard dash, and he won his second straight Superstars crown. Just three events to go. Jet skiing is our next event. It's going to take place outside Margaritaville in downtown Montego Bay. And let's find out how this thing works.
Here are the rules of the Jamaica jet skis.
It's a one-on-one race, all about Jamaica.
The race go like this.
Up and back.
Mr. Bowie, and it's 5 seconds.
The top two races for the championship.
Here we go with heat number one. This is Herschel Walker and Keyshawn Johnson. Herschel Walker showing everybody that he has done this before. Herschel turns in a time 3 seconds better than Johnson. He's at 31.66. It was Dorsey Levens and Lennox Lewis in heat number two. Levens won the battle between the two, but yet his time still well behind the two leaders. All right, the third heat, Alan Johnson and Cordell Stewart. Some fast times here. This one went right down to the wire, but Cordell Stewart turns in the best time so far, 30.9.
Yeah, not bad so far. We got Jason and the rest of the boys about to go out here and do a little something. So.
It's at Three Rivers and Pittsburgh.
Hopefully we get this thing done. If it's in Three Rivers, I think we may have it.
Jason Seahorn, our Superstars leader, is going to race next.
Hi, I'm Bob Carney, and we are one-on-one with Kobe Bryant. Kobe? Unbelievable game last night against the Knicks.
We ain't playing Knicks last
night. Let's take a look at the highlights. Whoa! What a move!
That was a nice move, man. That wasn't me, though.
How did you get so much air? You got up there and you just had the ball, and just 360, and woo! You were on fire!
Kobe Bryant in NBA courtside. All the moves, all the action, all the NBA you can jam in a game.
Wow. Let's have a moment of silence for the defense on that one.
Suspension and full range traction control. And while these features may seem somewhat dry on paper, drivers find them quite inspiring on other surfaces. Katerra, the caddy that zigs. Statistics show that 40% of all kids who smoke marijuana live in the city. Guess where the other 60% live?
The Superstar.
Welcome back to Jamaica. We're getting set for the next heats in the jet ski competition. A reminder that tonight on ABC, Will Friedle, Dabney Coleman, and Jay Thomas star in the world premiere of My Date with the President's Daughter on the Wonderful World of Disney. Then another chilling world premiere, Mind Games, tonight on ABC. Well, six competitors have tested the jet skis so far. Cordell Stewart, the best time. Herschel Walker, though, the time to beat if you want to make the finals.
The superstar.
In heat number four, we'll have Jason Sehorn going against J.J. Stokes. As they creep towards the start line. There's the green flag, and away they go. A good start, especially at the bottom for Sehorn. J.J. Stokes, as he's rounding some of the buoys, you can hear him having to back off on the throttle on his jet ski. A lot of lost time there.
Well, when you turn off your engine or cut back on it, you lose all your ability to make sharp turns.
Right now, Jason Sehorn just thinking about turning in a time that'll get him into the finals. Cordell Stewart, Herschel Walker, the two best times so far. Oh, and a good clean finish for Jason Sehorn, and he turns in a 30.40, the best time of the competition so far, knocking Herschel Walker out of the finals.
And Dan, I know you're a big jet skier, and I think the one thing about this event, the athletes enjoy this more than any other. And I also think that this man right here, Jason Sehorn, has been the surprise of this competition.
What should not come as a surprise to anyone is Johnny Mosley and how he pegs out the fun meter. Hard to find a guy who could have a better time than Johnny's had here at Margaritaville as he gets ready to ride the jet ski all by himself. The top two times now belong to Cordell Stewart and to Jason Sehorn. And look how Johnny Mosley gets way up front, almost over the top of the handlebars, as he rides the jet ski.
Well, the way he displaces his weight is absolutely perfect. He's right in the middle of the ski. That allows him to have the ability to make these sharp turns and get around the buoys and have an excellent time.
A very different technique from everybody else, and the quickest run so far by John Mosley. He comes in at 28.88. He knocks Cordell Stewart off the bubble. It'll be a Sehorn-Mosley final.
Superior technique by Mosley, riding high, shifting his weight from side to side. And you know Mosley's never going to back off that throttle.
Well, he turns in the best time by over a second and a half. Sent Cordell Stewart to the sidelines. Yeah. You got to pay the price.
Good shit, baby. Come on. Don't you pull me in here. I'll take it again.
Johnny, don't buy it. Don't buy it, John. Let's get set now for the finals of the jet ski competition. Jason Sehorn is at the top of your screen. Johnny Mosley at the bottom. He had the best qualifying time. They start inching towards the starting line. And there's the green flag when both of them are still at least 10 yards from the start. Sehorn towards the back of his Kawasaki. Mosley clear up front. John Mosley to this point in time has a slight lead. Oh, and right there at the top, Jason Sehorn spun out. And John Mosley wins the jet ski competition. Clearly the king of the jet ski competition. Don't try this at home. John Mosley celebrates in style.
Again, the key, Dan, is Mosley's style of riding close to the handlebars, almost like a dirt bike racer. And he gets through the buoys without any contact at all, and the 10-point finish.
And not only that, makes his goggles land right in the jet ski at the same time. So Mosley wins, Sehorn gets second. It's then Stewart, Walker, and Johnson rounding out the top five in the jet skis. And after eight events, Jason Sehorn in the lead by 7 3/4 points. Mosley, Walker, Levin, Stewart, and Johnson, the top six.
You thought it was over with, but you're still smoking. You keep trying to quit, but you keep lighting up.
Zyban can help you look at quitting a whole new way. It's the nicotine in cigarettes that's addictive. It's been proven. And most people need help to quit. Today, there's nicotine-free Zyban. Not a patch, not a gum. Instead, the first pill that is part of a comprehensive program from your doctor can help you quit smoking. Zyban is prescription medicine that can help reduce your urge to smoke and make quitting bearable. It's important to know there's a risk of seizure associated with Zyban. To reduce the risk, don't take Zyban if you've had an eating or seizure disorder or are being treated with Wellbutrin. Don't take Zyban if you're taking an MAO inhibitor. Quitting is tough, and Zyban won't work for everyone. See your doctor or pharmacist for information written especially for patients. Ask your doctor if Zyban is right for you. And break free from nicotine. Break free from smoking.
Monday, April 27th, Ally McBeal comes to ABC. Bobby Donnell, meet Ally McBeal. And don't miss the practice this Monday on ABC.
Heaven helps Old Man as he tries to juggle fatherhood and a social life.
I'll pick you up at 8.
Pick you up at 8, sweetheart.
You know, you're not too old for a spanking. No. Not you. Unless...
An all-new Soul Man between two home improvements, ABC Tuesday.
Would you know what to do if your child was in trouble? ABC 7, as part of our continuing commitment to put children first, is pleased to make available the one-hour special, Protect Our Children, Knowing the Rules, a revealing look at child safety in our changing world. If you would like a copy of this very special program for only the $5.95 cost of shipping and handling, please call 1-800-690-INFO. That's 1-800-690-4636. Watch as a family and learn how to protect our children.
Jane, my vision of healthcare lives in my head.
What about the benefits a business can expect?
The benefits are big, I tell you. Big.
Can a business expect savings and service or claims taken care of promptly?
Prompt is such a relative term.
Call and find out about HIP, the not-for-profit company with over 50 years of experience.
Call HIP or your broker and receive a free brochure on our business health plans and a 10-minute long-distance calling card.
How long has your company been in operation?
I'm really not sure. We've just met.
So, where do you get your health care?
It's HIP.
7 on Your Side takes the lid off takeout. Is It Something I Ate? Thursday at 11.
You're watching Nintendo Sports 25th Anniversary of the Superstars on ABC Sports. Johnny Mosley wins the jet ski, moves closer to Jason Sehorn. He also takes home a bonus for winning the event. At a reception out at Rose Hall, here's Barry Beeler of Kawasaki.
Now this doesn't go in the snow, but it goes in the water. But it's our pleasure to present Johnny with a top-of-the-line 1100 STX watercraft, the same vehicle he used to win the Kawasaki jet ski.
The Superstar.
Well, we're down to the final two events of the 1998 Superstars. Now it's the 100-yard dash. A good crowd has gathered here at Walter Fletcher Park. We have six competitors entered in the 100-yard dash. We'll run it in two heats. In heat number one, it's Lennox Lewis, Dorsey Levins, and Cordell Stewart. Cordell Stewart on the left wins the first heat in a time of 10.59. Dorsey Levins there in second place. Remember that the winner of each one of the heats makes the finals, plus the top three times behind them. Now, Mike Powell and Herschel Walker have had this wonderful rivalry over the years. They're both going to be running here in the second heat. These former superstar champions have a lot of pride.
Mike Powell, I think, is one of the best athletes in the world. And, you know, get an opportunity to compete against him and, you know, guys like that, you know, only get my blood going.
And it was back in 1993 when Powell beat Walker.
To run against Herschel, I was excited, but I was nervous and I was kind of intimidated. And when I won, I couldn't believe it. It was a great feeling.
Well, these past two superstar champions find themselves in this heat with Jason Sehorn, the newcomer. We're ready for the start. And a very good start for Herschel Walker, and Sehorn slips a little bit, Dan.
And he got off to a terrible start. Remember, they're running in sand, but I don't think Sehorn was going to catch these two.
Herschel Walker, an easy winner here in the second heat. Mike Powell was second. So Herschel Walker turns in the best time at 10.48. Mike Powell, 10.68. That's the third best time behind Cordell Stewart.
Two bad things happened to Jason Seahorn on the right of the screen at the start. He gets out of the blocks real slow and then slips. He doesn't quit, but he does follow the 36-year-old Walker to the finish line.
So the finals are set here for the 100-yard dash. In lane number one from the New York Giants, Jason Seahorn.
Come on. Have a little coconut juice before you go.
No, I know it's in that thing.
Johnny Mosley offers him a little refreshment. Cordell Stewart will be in lane two. In the middle, the man with the fastest qualifying time at 10.48, Herschel Walker. His arch rival right next door, Mike Powell. And rounding out the top five, Dorsey Levens of the Green Bay Packers. So certainly the attention will be riveted on the middle of the track, where Stewart, Walker, and Powell congregate. The 100-yard dash was never a big event of mine, Dan, much less having to run it on sand. A good, clean start. Cordell Stewart looks like he's got the lead. But Herschel Walker appeared to lean in at the end and break the tape. Cordell Stewart took a nasty tumble after he crossed the finish line.
It's definitely going to be a photo finish, but Herschel Walker's got a lot of experience with photo finishes. In 1987, he edged out Willie Gault at the finish line, and I think he just got enough lean to beat Cordell Stewart here.
Well, and remember, he has a sprinter's background, and he knows how to lean and maintain his balance at the same time, and Herschel Walker does break the tape with the body lean to edge out Cordell Stewart. And with the win, Herschel picks up 10 points. Stewart gets 7 for second. And then it's Powell, Levens, and Seahorn. As we check the overall standings after 9 events, Jason Seahorn has a comfortable lead, although Johnny Mosley can still win the competition. Herschel in third has no events remaining.
The obstacle course is next. Come on, come on, come on. Here come the superstars. Come on, come on, come on. This next event is hard. Come on, come on, come on.
A tough case of athlete's foot can stop you in your tracks. You get that itching, the cracking, the burning. That's when you want a medicine and back stuff. Boom! Tough Actin Tenactin. It cures even tough cases of athlete's foot. Get Tough Actin Tenactin.
When I decided to train for this, I heard it all. Jehu, you fool, this is the desert. Jehu, it's 110 degrees. Crazy things. I practice around 5-6 hours a day with the rumble pack. On the slopes, in the half pipe, Jehu is there. It's very spiritual. Just you and the mountain. And the snowboard. And the game.
1080 snowboarding only on Nintendo 64. Real close to the real thing.
I warn you, snowboarders. Watch out for Jehu.
Nothing slows Troy Aikman down. Not broken bones, herniated discs, crazed linemen, crazed women, MRIs, blurry eyes, black eyes, interceptions, interviews, bad reviews, pull-ups, push-ups, sit-ups, knee pain, back pain, head pain, big hits, high hits, low hits, late hits, frozen turf, soggy turf, astroturf, pull-downs, put-downs, fourth downs. But 3 to 4 times a day, he does stop for metrics. A nutrient-dense, high-octane food for people who never slow down. Not even for this commercial.
Troy, come on, just one more take.
Get a tough case of athlete's foot and you're benched. You get that itching, the cracking, the burning. That's when you want a medicine at Act Stuff. Boom! Tough Actin Tenactin. It cures even tough cases of athlete's foot. Get Tough Actin Tenactin.
ABC Wednesday. Drew's luck with women finally bottoms out. The solution? A dating class.
He's grinding me again.
Maybe he should take a dating lesson from Two Guys, a Girl, and a Pizza Place.
Where do I find this rebound girl?
I don't know.
Sure, where do guys meet you?
All new ABC Wednesday.
It's one of NASCAR's biggest events on the fastest, most competitive track in the world, the Talladega 500, next Sunday at 1 Eastern on ABC.
5 years ago, down in Cancun in 1993, Herschel Walker had some pedaling problems as he found himself clear off the bicycle course. He got back in it, but like everybody else in Cancun, he was chasing this guy, the Catholic Dave Johnson, who demonstrated to the world why he's a very special athlete, winning the first of two straight championships in the Superstars. The signature event of the Superstars, the reason that it is always last, is the obstacle course. Something different always happens during the course of this event. Some of the athletes have had it mastered. Guys like Edwin Moses go over without even touching the rope.
Everybody feeling good and right.
Ronaldo Nehemiah, the same. Willie Gault takes the high jump like a hurdle. And current participant Mike Powell, he's the record holder in this event, 21.12 back in 92.
You know, Dan, some guys just have all kinds of trouble with the obstacle course. It's usually the big guys like Dwight Stevenson. How about Reggie White? And Big Keith Byers says, I'm going around this baby.
Don't stop pushing now.
Even Herschel Walker's been wet. And he's gone under the bar. So has Eric Metcalf, whose father, Terry, your old teammate, Dan, competed in this event in 1976. And I think Buffalo quarterback Jim Kelly, he should have gone under the bar, too. You know, it might be tough, but it's certainly worth a try.
Well, here it is, the wall. And as you can tell, I'm over 6 feet tall. This thing is 12 feet high. Most of the competitors won't even bother with the rope when they come over to this side. They'll just come all the way down and land in the sand. The next obstacle here is the tube. Now, this thing is 12 feet long. Now, luckily, it's padded on top. The guys will crab through here, trying hard not to hit their head. Now, when they come out of here, they've got to be under control because the next thing here is a blocking sled. You've got to hit this straight. Most of the guys don't have any experience with this. One wrong move, and you've got this thing skewed off to the side, then you're in big trouble. And, Dan Fouts, as we look down the rest of this course, a lot of other pitfalls ahead.
A lot of trouble, Dan. Nimble feet here for the tires, then strong legs. 10 tires, a water jump, a high jump, 2 hurdles, and a sprint to the finish line. So as you can tell, a lot of ways to get into trouble on the obstacle course.
This course is no problem unless you make a mistake.
Ah, failure to go through the tires cleanly.
You know what I'm saying, yo? 5-second penalty.
Aha, that would be failure to clear the long jump.
You know what I'm saying, man? No. No, no, no.
Don't clear the high jump. Penalty.
No, no, no.
Vanessa, what are the 10-second penalties?
You don't attempt an obstacle. Penalty.
No, 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 no.
That is a big wall. If you don't clear it, it'll cost ya.
You know what I'm saying? No, 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 no. No, no, no.
Good luck from Jamaica.
Well, the standings are very simple. Jason Seahorn, if he takes fourth or above, will win the entire competition, and Johnny Mosley has to win the obstacle course to unseat Seahorn. We get ready for the second heat. In heat number one, Jake Reed posted a time of 32.62. In this one, we've got Keyshawn Johnson against Jason Seahorn. So we'll get a good look early as to what type of event this will be for Seahorn.
You know what you're going to hear, right?
Yeah. Commissioner Bob McAwee gets the competitors set at the start line.
When you're right, get set.
And they approach the wall. Seahorn grabs the rope and is over easily.
Johnson threw the tubes cleanly, and Seahorn blocking like you did, Dan, but right there he missed a tire.
Jason Seahorn will have a penalty because he missed the tire.
And Keyshawn will have a few as well as he goes under the high bar.
Boy, a very good race for Jason Sehorn, except a five-second penalty puts his time at 28.42.
Gotta be able to move. Gotta be able to jump. To go over that wall. Woo!
I swung out.
Do you do a Tarzan?
Swung out.
All right, let's get set now for the third heat of the obstacle course. Gold medalist Alan Johnson, who won the 110 hurdles in Atlanta. He'll be in the far lane, and he's going against Mike Powell, who is the record holder in this event. He set it back in 92 with a 21-12. One of the few guys that goes over this wall without using the rope. Powell in the near lane. Johnson in the far. And Mike Powell, his foot slips and he runs right into the wall. Alan Johnson going solo here in the obstacle course.
And he's got some problems of his own as he goes through the tires, but nowhere to be seen is Mike Powell.
Well, no wonder. Mike Powell hit that wall hard. And Alan Johnson goes on and finishes the obstacle course alone. But what a shot Mike Powell took when he hit the wall.
Well, you said he doesn't use the rope. Maybe he should use the rope.
At least Mike is all right, up and walking around. And he's looking at that wall like he's been betrayed. He just can't leave here without doing it, Dan. He's got to prove it to himself.
And so he does, over the wall easily, just a little bit late.
Another look here at Mike Powell as he just hits that wall hard after his foot slips.
Sometimes the windshield, sometimes the bug.
Poor Mike.
I got going a little too fast and I didn't get my the right kind of plant on the board, on the wall, and I went to the new side of the wall where the paint was, and my foot just slipped and crashed. That's the chance you take. I should have used spikes. But I've had fun down here. I'll see you next year.
Well, now that we've had our levity break, let's get set for the fourth heat. That's Johnny Mosley, the gold medalist steer from Nagano, and Cordell Stewart, the quarterback of the Pittsburgh Steelers. 10 seconds, you got about 10 seconds before the start of this race. The wall awaits. Both of these guys elect to use the rope. Mosley the first over the wall.
And but how well can he move the blocking sled, Dan? Not a bad job.
Johnny Mosley made it through the tires cleanly. And very nicely over the high jump bar.
Stewart knocked the bar down, so that's a penalty.
A good run for John Mosley.
I love him.
Cordell is the man.
Well, watching both of these guys use the ropes, I think it's safe to say they saw Mike Powell on the previous run. The important thing on this run right here, it puts John Mosley into the finals.
They didn't give you a chance.
It'll be Mosley against Alan Johnson in the finals. But the story here, Jason Sehorn finishes third in the obstacle course. That's good enough to make him the 98 Superstars champion.
The Superstar.
Has anyone seen my stress management presentation?
Where's my Hamlet essay, I pray?
I doth trashed it.
If you have an iOmega Zip Drive, your family can keep track of everything.
Military school information. You seen it?
What?
So make copies of all your stuff on 100 megabyte zip disks, so nothing gets lost. Almost.
Hello? Anyone see my retainer?
Get an iOmega Zip Drive today, because it's your stuff.
Katera
has full-range traction control and speed-sensitive steering to help you avoid all those clowns out there. Caterra, the caddy that zigs. The roster of champions here in the Superstars competition is deep and it is rich. Bob Segrin was our first champion back in 1973. Kyle Rowe Jr., he won it three times in a span of 4 years back in 74 through 77. Our only four-time winner in the early 80s was Ronaldo Nehemiah. A man who's still competing today, Herschel Walker, won this event in 87 and 88. Willie Gault took over for Herschel and won it back-to-back in 89 and 90. And then Dave Johnson, again back-to-back winner in 93 and 94. And now we come to 1998, and our winner, Jason Sehorn. He's with Dan Fouts right now.
Okay, thanks a lot, Dan. Listen, Jason Sehorn, congratulations. 1998 superstar.
Not a bad weekend in Jamaica, if I say so.
Are you surprised there's a lot of people?
Yeah, I was. I mean, I thought I'd come out and compete with everybody. To what extent, I didn't know until I got out here, and I was able to come out here and just do well with the God-given abilities I have.
The final five events, you had to participate in all of them. That's quite a grind.
Oh, that was a grind. Let me tell you, these last few events, that 100, the monkey jumped on my back. I didn't have anything left as I was running down there. But, just with the condition that I'm able to do during the offseason, I was ready for it and able to compete and do well.
What was the key for you in your preparation? Do you remember?
Yeah, two things. One, back home, I swim a lot with Jason Williams, the Nets, and we ride a lot of stationary bikes with the Giants. So, you know, the bicycling and the swimming kind of propelled me over the rest of these guys.
All right. Well, so after the preliminary heats and the obstacle course, it's all over. Jason Sehorn is our champion, but we still have more Johnny Mosley. Dan, back to you.
All right, Mr. Fouts, let's go to the starting line for the finals here in the obstacle course. A lot of gold in this silver anniversary of the Superstars competition.
And in the red lane.
Alan Johnson, the gold medalist in the summer games, against John Mosley, a gold medalist from the winter games. And this means a great deal to Johnny Mosley. He participated in the Olympics in an event that some people didn't take seriously, and I think he's proven that he is indeed a world-class athlete. Alan Johnson with the quickest time in the preliminaries, over the wall in a hurry.
Mosley having a lot of trouble. Looks like he's run out of gas. But Johnson showing his athletic ability and hurdling ability. Goes over the water, over the high bar, and it's an easy sprint to the finish line for him.
So Alan Johnson easily wins the obstacle course. Johnny Mosley comes in second. And a good competition for both of these athletes. And right away, this race was won with the ease in which Johnson went over the wall. So let's check the final results of the 25th anniversary of the Superstars. Jason Sehorn with 49 points. A really good outing for Johnny Mosley at 43 and a quarter. If you look at that second page, I think those five would like to do it one more time. So congratulations to Jason Sehorn. We'll be back here to wrap things up right after this.
W1 by Raymond Weil. The cutting edge in time. Time for the next generation. W1 by Raymond Weil.
Hi, I'm Bob Carney, and we are one-on-one with Kobe Bryant. Kobe, unbelievable game last night against the Knicks.
They played the Knicks last
night. Let's take a look at the highlights. Whoa, what a move!
move.
That was a nice move. That wasn't me, though.
How did you get so much air? You got up there and you just had the ball and 360 and woo! You were on fire.
Kobe Bryant in NBA courtside. All the moves, all the action, all the NBA you can jam in a game.
Wow. Let's have a moment of silence for the defense on that one.
Is in the air with Air Jamaica's Lovebirds. Complimentary champagne, the finest meal service in the skies, and our famous Lovebird hospitality. So fly with us and experience Jamaica before you even get there. Call your travel agent or 1-800-523-5585.
Nintendo Sports 25th Anniversary of the Superstars. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by Nintendo Sports. Tenactin. For tough cases of athlete's foot, there's Tough Actin Tenactin. The new Zip built-in drive from iOmega. Include one in your next computer. And Katera, the caddy that zigs.
When you win $35,000, there is no reason to be crabby. Jason Sehorn on the right, our champion, standing there with Johnny Mosley. Congratulations, Jason. Hey, did you have fun, Vanessa?
When I found I was coming out here to Jamaica, I thought that the island was going to be the most beautiful thing that I had ever seen. And it was. Until I hung out with these guys. These guys are true athletes. They are true superstars. They're competitive, they're devoted, and they're just so much fun. But most of all, they're really nice guys. So I have to tell you that I got what I came out here looking for and a whole lot more. And I hope you guys did too.
Thanks, Vanessa, and our congratulations to Jason Sehorn, who goes into the record books as the winner of the 25th anniversary of the Superstars. Next on ABC Sports, it's the Hershey's Kisses Figure Skating Challenge featuring Michelle Kwan and Nancy Kerrigan. Hotel accommodations have been provided by the Half Moon Bay Resort, one of the world's top 50 golf, tennis, and beach resorts. And air transportation provided by Air Jamaica. Air Jamaica is the number one airline to Jamaica. We've had several very enjoyable days down here in Jamaica watching these world-class athletes compete in a variety of different events. Our congratulations to champion Jason Sehorn. And for Vanessa Marcel and Dan Fouts, I'm Dan Dierdorf. Let's go back now to our Wide World studios and our host, Robin Roberts.
All right, Dan, thank you very much. I know tough work, but someone's got to do it. Jason Sehorn making the G-men proud like that. Coming up next, it's the Hershey's Kisses Figure Skating Challenge featuring Tara Lipinski. It is the final day of the NBA.